Good morning.
Today we will discuss about projection of planes. First of all, we have to understand what is a plane. So a plane, or sometimes called as lamina, or a plate, sometimes a plate is also used in the questions. So it is a two-dimensional surface having length and breadth with a negligible thickness. So suppose we have a paper, okay, it is a rectangular shape. Generally it will be a rectangular shape and the thickness will be negligible. So if a plane is that kind of thing. Now in engineering drawing, we are going to see all these different types of planes that are there. These are displaced here, and these planes sometimes they are joined by, and generally if a line is group of points and number of lines joined to form a plane. So if we, here it is mentioned non-collinear points. So suppose this is one point, this is one point, this is one point, this is one point. So they are not collinear. So any diagram, if you take here we need 5 corners. If we join all these 5 non-collinear points, then we will get a plane. See here, if we join all the 6 non-collinear points, we'll get a plane. So like that, if any three non-collinear points are joined, then the plane is formed. And sometimes it is bound by a straight lines, and sometimes it is bound by a curved lines, like in case of a semicircle, ellipse, circle, we have curved lines, and remaining pentagon, hexagon, rhombus, triangle, square, rectangle, we have a straight lines. So these things may be regular figures or irregular figures. So if all the sides are equal, here in pentagon and a hexagon, rhombus, triangle, square, these are all regular figures or regular planes. And irregular planes means here is there. Is this a semicircle? It is a irregular figure. So we have to, these are the different types of planes that are used in engineering drawing. Now how these planes are placed, that is the major question that we have to discuss. So it can be parallel to one plane and perpendicular to the other planes. Say we have three planes: HP, horizontal plane; VP, vertical plane; and PP, profile plane. So in which orientation our plane, the rectangular plane or any other regular plane or circular plane, is placed, that is what is the question. So here the first type of question is, if the plane is parallel to one of the principal planes and perpendicular to the other two principal planes. The next one is, the plane is perpendicular to one of the principal plane and inclined to other two principal planes. The third one is, the plane is inclined to all the three principal planes. So one by one we will see how to draw the orthographic projections for these things. The first thing, if we see here, observer is there. This is the vertical plane and this is the horizontal plane. This is the profile plane. The plane is perpendicular to, this is a rectangular plane here, and the plane is perpendicular to vertical plane and horizontal plane, and it is parallel to profile plane. So in this kind of cases, we'll see from the side view, we can see the true shape of the plane. Okay. And in front view and top view, we'll see only lines. This is a line and this is a line. If you observe, you're seeing from here, you will see a line. And if you're seeing from the top, you will see a line. So this is a about if the plane is perpendicular to both HP and VP and it is parallel to profile plane. Similarly, if the plane is parallel to HP and perpendicular to VP and profile plane, here the side profile plane will be there. Here the plane is parallel to HP, perpendicular to VP and profile plane. Now observer is looking from here, in front view he will see a line and in top view he will see the true shape of the true shape and size of the plane. So this is what this we have to visualize, keeping one any plane in front of us. And this is the orthographic projections here. This is the front view and this is the top view, and here A, V, C, D is there, and in front view A dash in brackets B dash is there, because B dash is, B is hidden and A is visible. Here C is hidden and D is visible. So D is outside bracket, C is inside brackets. So next one is, if the plane is perpendicular to HP and profile plane and it is parallel to vertical plane, in this case how what will be the orthographic projections. So if the observer is seeing from the front, he will see the true shape of the plane. So and then if he is seeing from the top, he will see a line. So if the plane is perpendicular to HP and parallel to VP, then in front view you will see the true shape of the figure or true shape of the plane, and in top view you will see a line parallel to XY. So this is the in this way you will draw the orthographic projections. By the way, here if the plane is parallel to HP, then we have to start drawing the orthographic projections with the top view, because in top view you will see the true shape of the object. If it is a rectangle, we can determine this length, but if it is a pentagon or hexagon and all, then first thing what we have to do, anything, that is why anything, whatever we are drawing, whether it is hexagon, pentagon, square, rectangle, rhombus or anything, if the plane is parallel to HP, first step is to draw the top view. Draw the top view, from the top view, from all the points, drop the projections and you will get a line parallel to XY, and this line is the front view. Similarly, if the plane is parallel to VP, we'll start drawing the diagram with the front view. So because in front view you'll see the true shape and size of the object. If plane is parallel to VP, the in front view you'll see the true shape, true size and shape of the object. So we'll start drawing with the front view, A dash, B dash, C dash and D dash. And the top view, after drawing the front view, drop the projections and you draw a line at the given distance and you will get the top view. Okay, so then if the plane is perpendicular to VP and inclined to HP, so what is happening here? If the observer is seeing from the front, he will see on a line, only a line, but it is inclined to xy. Now what is this angle? This angle is nothing but the angle made by the plane with HP. Okay, so here if the observer is seeing from the front, he will see a line which is inclined at an angle theta with xy. What is the theta? The theta is inclination of the plane with HP. And in top view, he will see a reduced shape. Here this is a big plane, but in top view he will see a reduced one. And if the similarly, if the plane is perpendicular to HP and inclined to VP, then in the front view he will see the reduced shape of the plane, and in top view he will see the inclined line or inclination with the line and the inclination of the plane with the VP. Both the things